everyone. This is Devin Drake from DB Services, and I'm here with a video for the FileMaker JavaScript integration. Here I just have a small demo file that will demonstrate the communication between a web viewer and FileMaker, and then FileMaker to the web viewer. And how this is achieved now is with JavaScript, we now have the ability to do FileMaker.performScript, which will perform a FileMaker script without the need of an FMP URL. And with FileMaker to the web viewer, we now have a script step called perform JavaScript function in web viewer. And so, without further ado, let's get into it. On the left here, I have an editor that has the capability of running FileMaker scripts. What it will just do is the save button will take whatever content is in here and save it to this content field. This one right here is just a web viewer to show what your content will look like in HTML. So if I come in here and just do this is test content and click save, as you can see, we have that right here. And in our code, we have the actual HTML tags for everything. And how this is achieved is the web viewer has that button, which calls a method. That method's called save changes. And what this does is it will save the content in a JSON object, and then URL encode that here. And then we do this FileMaker.performScript, where we pass in the script name and the encoded params. And when that gets ran here, it will run the script generic editor content. And what this does is it grabs the script parameters. In this case, since it is URL encoded, we wrap this in our custom function URL decode. And then we will grab the content from that. And then after that, it's just simply saving the content to the content field, committing, and then exiting the script. A consideration that you will have to be wary of is there is a new option in the web viewer setup. It is going to be the last one here, allow JavaScript to perform FileMaker scripts. So you will need this on for that to work. And that is communication between the web viewer to FileMaker. And the next one is this clear content button, which demonstrates communication from FileMaker to the JavaScript or the web viewer. And so, what this will actually do is clear the content in the editor without clearing the content in the content field. So I'll click that here, and notice how we still see content goes here. This is test content in our other web viewer. And we have all the content still here in the content field. And how that works here is if we open up scripts, that button is just clear editor content. And we have the perform JavaScript and web viewer script step here. And we do have some options that you need to be aware of is the object name, which again, my editor was called web editor, and the function name. And as you can see here, it's not just our function name, clear content, which if I bring the code over here, we have the clear content function here. It's not just that. What you will have to be mindful of is if you're using JavaScript or one of JavaScript's popular frameworks such as React, Vue, or Angular. In that case, you will need to do a little bit of digging. In our case, the clear content function was in our app.view. So we go to app, its first child, and then that was where clear content was. So we are able to call it that way. As far as error trapping goes, you can do your standard FileMaker error trapping for the script step itself, but if you are wanting to make sure that the JavaScript function runs as intended, you will need to do your error trapping within the code. I just have a simple try catch here. If for whatever reason it cannot clear the content, it will give out an alert right here. So with that, as you saw, when I pressed cleared content, it cleared out the content of the editor, but it did not clear out the content of the code. And again, that will be everything that we will cover, is the communication between the web viewer and FileMaker, and vice versa, the communication between FileMaker and web viewer. If you need assistance with JavaScript web viewers and FileMaker, please contact DB Services and we'll be happy to help you. Thank you, have a wonderful day.